Hello everyone, and welcome back to another session of Dark Souls 3 Focused PvP. Today we are picking up with Anor's Straight Sword and the Soldering Iron, because... yeah.
Hello.
It's just one of those days where we're gonna use some pretty... well, to be fair, the Straight Sword is actually solid. But... soldering iron is not so much. Oop. I was supposed to go into an R1 with that, but that didn't work. And there's the kill. Even with subpar damage on this thing, due to the fact that I don't have any luck, it's a straight sword, so it's perfectly fine. My primary concern for this episode is going to be the soldering iron, but maybe we'll get lucky. It is a fun weapon. I'll admit that. It is a fun weapon. I do like the fact that it can block healing, so that is a good thing for invasions. Yeah. Other than that, though, I mean, it does have good fire-based damage, to be fair. I don't think it can actually be infused. If it could be infused, if you made it a fire infusion, that would actually be really nice. But I doubt that it can. It would be nice, though. I mean, in a perfect world. Karthus Curved Sword, oh boy. I'm expecting some bleed to be put on that? No. Oh. Okay, then. Strafing around like that shouldn't have been possible, but okay then. Also, very annoying that that's a combo that you can do now, the skill into R1, R1. I'm not a fan of that. Because if you did the skill and went to the R2, it actually would deal less damage than doing the skill R1, R1. The 3 hits done on that just... it's silly. The skill hitting for all of those hits, that makes sense. Because it's a bit more speedy, but, well, here. Let's just do a little comparison, speed-wise. It's around here somewhere. That compared to that. It covers more distance, so, it is what it is. And I guess it's very close to being the same speed, but the fact that the R1 R1 actually hits for more damage with it is a tad silly. Still, that weapon, I mean, that thing has a lot of damage behind it, 433. And with the bleed on there as well, had he been buffing, we have Onishiri Udachi. That was a solid 150 damage. I'll take that. Oh yeah. That damage though. Gotta give props for that. And that's not a horn ring either, I don't believe. A little too early on that parry. If I'd gone for an R1, that would have been it. That was actually a surprisingly enjoyable fright. An enjoyable fright, yes. That was a surprisingly enjoyable fight from someone using Onikiri Nubidachi. He also switched to what I believe was Uchikatana, I think. Unless I'm going crazy. But I know when he switched to the parrying dagger, I think he switched his main weapon as well. We're seeing a lot more of that Karthus Curved Sword, by the way. I'm not a big fan. Very long-reaching weapon, lots of damage, bleed, scary stuff. I mean, it's a good weapon. I've always said it's a good weapon. I was surprised when it wasn't overly common to begin with. But now that it's becoming more common, it's becoming more of a pain, because you're getting a lot of people who are able to do the extremely easy roll catch with it, where you just take a slight step forward and press R1 between hits. So you're getting a lot of people doing that with it, which you can't punish people going for a roll catch. It just doesn't work. Two-handed, going for the skill. Solid distance. Death. Couldn't get out. Solid fight. Had a good bit of distancing on that. Charged R2, got a nice counter hit on that, I think. That was a counter hit at the very least. All things considered, went pretty well. Had I been using a different longsword, it would have been a little bit better. I was thinking, for whatever reason, that my attack would have reached him before his hyper armor frames had initiated, but it wasn't the case. I expected more. Shouldn't have. That guy I tried to summon was using Smo's hammer, but bit of a shame I didn't get him. That would have been a fun fight. I've got to say, though, I actually am really enjoying using Anri's Straight Sword. It doesn't have the damage that the other Straight Swords have. It's, for me, the least damaging, aside from the Cleric's Candlestick. But that doesn't even count, in my opinion. And, again, not counting the Broken Straight Sword, because that would just be stupid to count that. I don't even have an upgraded Short Sword, so I can't even compare that. But I would assume that it's higher than not even 300. I would assume. So. Usually the standard short sword is about 10 to 20 lower than a long sword, if previous Souls games are anything to judge by. So I'd assume it's around there as well. So, you know, broadsword's now the highest damaging for me, at the very least. Yeah, you get the idea. Hello, Tarkus. What do you got for me? Get out of that sooner. Roll catching. Oop, that's a problem. Can I magic fix my way through this? This is not going well. If he had gone for a rolling attack then, that would have been death. I didn't expect him to go for another attack. He hadn't done that at all. Oh yes, yes. Well, what is it? Because I was totally, you know, hitting good damage on you. Had I been using a different weapon, you know, one that actually did damage. But whose fault is that? This guy. That said, I did get him about to halfway down on his health. Hitting under 150 for almost every single hit. I can't really complain about that. Like, I think I played pretty decently, all things considered. But now it's time for this. And now, this. It's got a decent moveset. I mean, it's spear. It's basically just, well, it's exactly just the standard spear moveset. I actually don't know what's longer, this or the standard spear. Yeah, this is longer. Just barely, but it is. I wonder what its damage is classified as. Standard damage. Okay, that makes sense, because it's clearly not a thrust. Partisan, nonetheless. Ooh, the range on that. No, not coming on that. No. There's the parry. I knew it would be coming, I knew the attack would be there eventually. Run away for a second, ow. That was actually a really fun fight. That was actually a really fun fight. I like that turtle pokes are just slightly off with their timing. In hindsight, actually two-handing and going for the skill when he had a Malbreaker, not a Malbreaker, a Parrying Dagger out, that was extremely stupid and really could have backfired and should have backfired, because all he would have had to do is hold his ground and press parry at any point during me hitting him, and because it's a multi-hit attack, I would have been dead. It would have been very, very bad. Oh, my neck. Well, my neck doesn't feel as stiff now, so there's that. Wolf Knight Greatsword, fun weapon. No, Wolner's. It did get a buff. The question is, how good is it? Okay. Never mind, my shield is up, but okay. That should have hit me. There we go, now we're even. Oh, not the attack I thought. That's actually a solid combo, wow. Props. Props, for real. I didn't know that that was a combo. That's a good three hit. I wonder if you could do it with R2s instead. I need to start working on the bow cleric again, but I don't really have the motivation for it, you know, because even just using bows in PvP, they're bad. Bows are just not good in this game. If we could infuse them, then I'd have more of a motivation to do it. if we could hold more arrows, I would have more of a motivation. I'd have more motivation to do it. But as things stand, I'll do it eventually. It's just, it won't be good. I was looking forward to it so much after seeing you could move around with bows and do bow rolling attacks and running attacks. But with the tracking on arrows being what it is, with the fact that you can literally just... It's bad. It's just bad. Here I was hoping it would be, you know, a cross between Dark Souls 2 with damage and utility and add on additional movement features. But that's just not the case. So... That's fair. Hooray for near instant bleed. And the bravo, the sassy clapping. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. Maybe someday they'll realize the mistake they made, but won't be today. Hopefully next patch. See, the issue in my opinion, it's the fact that two things, first off, with Onikiri, Nubidachi, and Claws. I've explained it before. One, when they actually jump into you, that initial stun should not cause bleed. On top of that, it should not cause the equivalent of two hits of bleed, one for each weapon. That alone is an issue. On top of that, though, weapons actually gain the effects of a buff equally to each other when you're using dual weapons. That's why dual weapons are so dangerous when buffed and why they seem to deal way more damage than they should. And that applies to bleed as well. So, essentially, when you hit with that attack, it's the equivalent of hitting with four hits of bleed in one attack. Understandably, that's not an okay thing. Add in the fact that they already have good damage, and they have the capability of headshot, and if you do get the headshot, you're into another combo with its skill, or with its, not skill, but with its L1. Adding on another two hits. That's got me. Stay one-handed for me. Okay, fine. Oh yeah, that 68 damage. So worth it. That again. Could have gotten a backstab, went for a parry instead. My own fault. Tried to roll sideways. Rolled behind him instead. Ha ha. Oop, that's a problem. No, 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 no. You don't throw out parries like that. Only I throw out parries like that. That was a really bad miss, man. That was a really bad miss. I'll take it. Normally I would let that pass, because that's just a really bad miss. But for the weapon I'm using, I'll take what I can get. Finally, it's over though, I can switch it up. It's about time. Whew. Not gonna lie, I was starting to get pretty bored playing a bit more defensively. It was a good fight, but man, I hate playing that defensively. I really, really do. I had to play way too reactive for my taste. A katana, long cast blade. When did you put the buff on? For real though, does that look buff to anyone but me? I'll take it with that. It'll deal more damage. And that's my issue with multi-hit attacks. They bounce off. And the counter. Solid. Yeah, it's a sad day when you know that a riposte with the soldering iron will deal more than the one from a straight sword. It's a sad day. That was a good fight though. I'm proud of myself for that one, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, well, it is now the time to decide what we're doing on the next episode. So first we're gonna use the harp. And second, we are going to use a thing. A thingy thing. Blacksmith hammer. The harp and blacksmith hammer, guys. That's the plan. A little bit of spam thrown in. Trying to go for a rolling R1 then. That much is very clear. Eh? Death. I thought he was gonna roll. Being on the stairs and backed against a wall, I really expected a roll. That's the way it goes. Ugh. My back has just been really stiff. My back and my neck. It's annoying. It's a nuisance. I'm not sure about the blacksmith hammer, though, for next time, in all honesty. I feel like there's something a little bit more entertaining that I could be using that I haven't used yet. Like his Y-hander. I don't think I've actually used his Y-hander yet. Who doesn't like big heavy swords? I'm gonna check if I looked up his Y-hander, yes. I'm gonna just check if I've used his Y-hander. Give me 1 second. Da-da-da-da, I'll go over here. Go over there. So tomorrow, the day that this is actually going to go live, it is Becca's birthday. So today we went and got her a new phone. I butchered the spelling on that. So yesterday I got the fish tank. We've not done the Zweihander. We'll do the Zweihander and the harp. Dragon Slayer Axe. Good weapon. You can actually buff it, even though it has 210 lightning base. And that makes it very, very scary. Because buffs are necessary against the soldering iron. Oh, the roll catch on that. That was nice. Yeah, as you guys can see though, massive damage. Tried to go for a parry. Yeah, massive damage. Oh yes, and throw out the parry to make fun of me for it. Because there was definitely another way I could have turned that around easily. Yeah. Yeah, I don't understand why that is one of two weapons that actually has split damage that can still be buffed, the other one being the Dragon Slayer, not Dragon Slayer, Drake Blood, great sword. Because despite it being split multiple ways, it can still be buffed. Why? I don't know. But because FromSoft, basically. They decided to give Faith builds some pretty good stuff this time around. But yeah, that axe. This guy. When refined, 210 lightning base. I don't know if that... Well, I'm sure it does, but I don't know what that changes to. If it's either infused along a heavy or... whatever it is for Dex weapons skill. I don't know. I don't remember. I only use refined and heavy for my muscle mage, but... yeah. Scary weapon. Actually, I don't think I've ever used that one either. Need some stamina. Bad management. Ooh. That was cool. I knew that too, though. If that's how we're going to be, I'll just do that. If that's really how we're going to be. If you don't want to have a fun fight, then I'll not have a fun fight with you. Because come on, really running around for the backstab when I'm doing an R1? Really, really? one final fight, and then we'll call it. That was a shame, too. That was a fun fight to start, and then it just got really cheesy. I hate when that happens. I hate when people run around your side to go for a hit trade and get the backstab. I hate when they do that with great shields to mitigate the damage lost. They really directly reduce the damage. Damage dealt, not damage lost, but you know what I mean. I don't like it. It shouldn't be a thing. It's just as bad as poise backstabs were, kinda. Not really. Poise backstabs were infinitely worse, but it's the same concept. It shouldn't be a thing. Like, it should not be a thing, but it is. What was that sword? Ah, Cathedral. No, Lothric Greatsword. Oh yeah, that's another one that can be buffed that has lightning, isn't it? Very dangerous. Gotcha. No. Ooh. I do have to say, I like what he's got going on. Shouldn't have run in on that. Ooh, going for a third, okay. Aw, close. The stun on that hit was too long, I couldn't get into the R1 soon enough. Had I been able to, it would have been the end of him. But he came out of his recovery more quickly than I did. That was a good fight. I like what he had going on right there. I like the stylistic thing he was doing, using the Lothric Knight weapons. It was cool. And his name was Elite Knight too, so very fitting. Very, very fitting. I like that. Either way though, guys, I hope you all enjoyed this one. I had a good time with it, surprisingly. I really enjoyed the weapons I was using, which is odd considering they are so not good for what I usually would be doing for my build for anything. So, yeah, no complaints. Either way, though, like I said, hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you all next time when I use the harp and maybe a Zweihander, maybe the blacksmith hammer. I don't know. We will see when the time comes. So, see you.